Hello, everyone. Welcome on another episode of a PEFC public consultation webinars. Today, we are talking about the Norwegian Forest Certification System. Our agenda is very similar as for the other webinars. You will hear from my side a brief presentation about PEFC International. And then I'm very happy to have here Thomas Husum from PEFC Norway, who will have a detailed presentation about the Norwegian Forest Certification System. And then at the end, we will have time for questions and answers. My name is Hubert Inheiser. I'm a technical officer at PEFC International, and I'm happy to be your host today. So let's get started with an introduction about PEFC International. The acronym stands for Program for the Endorsement of Forest Certification Systems. We are an alliance of independent national forest certification systems under the umbrella of PEFC International. All of these national forest certification systems are based on PEFC's sustainability benchmark standards or international standards. This is a purely voluntary mechanism promoting sustainable forest management through independent third-party certification. We are very proud that we are the world's largest forest certification system and provider of 3/4 of the world's certified and sustainably managed timber. Here you can see a global coverage of our system. And out of this, I'm happy to share that Norway is contributing to the European figure with an impressive more than 7 million hectares and almost 100 chain of custody certificates. Now, a bit of details about this assessment of the Norwegian Forest Certification System. The system itself was submitted in August this year for assessment. This assessment will be carried out by an independent assessor, yet to be appointed. We don't have the concrete assessor as of today. Part of this assessment is a 60-day international public consultation. We opened it today on the 26th of September, and we are encouraging all stakeholders to have their comments submitted on this link on the slide until 24th of November. Please note that all these comments submitted to PEFC International during this public consultation period will be considered by the assessor in the assessment report. So once again, the deadline is 24th of November of this public consultation. And here we are with this brief introduction, and I am happy to have Thomas here with us. I will stop sharing my screen and I will ask Thomas to take over and guide us through the Norwegian Forest Certification System. Thomas, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Hubert. And thank you for the introduction. I will also, my video on. You can see and hear me.
We can hear you, Thomas, but not yet see you. The presentation is online, but you are missing.
Okay. I will
there we are. Video. All good.
Yes. Okay. Hello, and thank you for your introduction, Hubert. I have, as you mentioned, set up a presentation for the PEFC Forest Certification System. My name, as you mentioned, is Thomas Husum, and I'm the National Secretary in PEFC Norway. And the agenda for my presentation is first a short presentation and introduction on Norwegian forestry, and then information on the PEFC system in Norway, And the third point is information about the national revision that we have had going for the last 2 years, from 2020 to now 2022. This is the things I will get back to in the presentation. First, a little screen about the Norwegian forest and forestry. Norway are part of the Nordic countries with Sweden, Finland, Denmark, and Iceland. A bit about the forest in the southern forest, southern Norway, and in good localities a little further north. In the Western Europe, we find some areas with broad-leaved forest, which is the northernmost offshoot of the European temperate broad-leaved forests. But in the rest of the country, up to the forest border, we find the conifer forest, which is the westernmost offshoot of the large boreal conifer forest of the whole northern Euro-Asia. The Norwegian forests are dominated by a small number of tree species that are found over large parts of the country, and that's spruce, pine, and birch. And together, these three species make up about 90% of the standing forest volume in Norway. Forest owners in Norway. About 125,000 forest properties is registered in Norway with more than 2.5 hectares of forest. And the average forest property is 50 hectares. The productive forest areas is mainly private and family owned. And as you see in the numbers here, 80% is private, owned by private persons, family owned, 6% other private, 9% is state owned, and 3% is municipalities, and we have 2% with the other owners. Short figure on the land and forest area. In Norway, we have about 12 million hectares of forest area, which covers about 38% of the mainland. Of the forest area, 71% is productive forest, and then 29% is unproductive. And on the productive forest area, forestry is practiced on approximately 50% of these areas. And I will get a bit more back to that those numbers later. Growing stock, annual increment, and fallings. Growing stock in Norway is about 1 billion cubic meters. And that volume has tripled over the last 100 years. Annual increment is 24 million cubic meter. And annual harvest is just under 14 million cubic meter. And of that annual harvest, 11.6 million cubic meter in 2021 was harvested for industry purpose. And as you see, two-thirds of that is spruce, one-third pine, and a small amount of broadleaf trees, and that's mainly birch. In addition to that, for the industry, 2.1 million cubic meters is harvested for other purpose, and that's mainly firewood, and a lot of that is birch. Okay, the productive forests and the tree species. As I mentioned before, we have not, or the it's the Norwegian spruce, the Scots pine, and the broadleaf, and mainly birch, which is the tree species in Norway. And the forestry and forestry industry is based on the Norway spruce and Scots pine. And here you see an figure about the distribution on the maturity classes. And you have one from 1919 and then one from 2019. So approximately in 30 years, you can see that the old mature stands has been developing quite good. And it's now growing from 29 to 43% with the old and mature stands in the Norwegian forest. The next thing, which is an important thing in the Norwegian forestry, is something called MIES and environmental inventories in forests. And the aim is to improve the knowledge of biodiversity in forest and thereby contribute to improved detection, monitoring, and management of environmental assets in the forest. It was developed in between 1997 and 2000, and it has been a part of the forest planning since 2002. And based on the, it's based on the registration of 12 main types of habitats, which is of particular importance to biodiversity in forests. And these are recorded in the National Forest Inventory. And it, this is also a very important part of the forest certification, as it is the basis for the key habitats. And this is a mandatory thing to be done on properties before harvest. And so far we have about 100,000 hectare, 70,000 key habitats set aside over the last 20 years. And it's cover approximately 1.7% of the productive forest area. Yes. Just make the. This is one very important thing. Another important thing to follow up in the forestry and is the amount of dead wood, since this is a very important habitat for many species. And as you see, we have an steady growth of dead wood in the forest, the Norwegian forest. And over the last 20 years, it has increased with 43%. So we now have about 11 cubic meter per hectare in the productive forest as dead wood. And in total, almost 100 million cubic meter is dead wood in the productive forest. And the volume of dead wood is greatest, of course, in the maturity class 5, the old mature forests. And here it has also increased over the period of time. So just last here, picture of the restrictions on forestry in Norway. Have restrictions due to the requirements through the certification and also the law. Some important things here is, of course, the key habitats and also the buffer zones along lakes and waterways and areas for important for wildlife and wildlife habitats, wetlands and swamp forests, rich deciduous forest, and mountain forest and protections forest. And in addition, of course, it is the forest protection, nature reserves and national parks, and protected landscapes. So approximately as a total, about 30% of the productive forest is in Norway is affected by restrictions. And we also use the wording or the expression with non-economical viable forest due to inaccessible terrain and it, due to the fact that it's far from roads. So all in all, forestry is practiced on about 50% of the productive forests in Norway. Also regulations. Here are some of the main acts and regulations regarding forests and forestry. We have the Act on Forestry, Act on Managing the Diversity of Nature, Act on Outdoor Life, Act on Cultural Heritage Site and Monuments, Act on the Right to Environmental Information, and Act on Streams and Groundwater. And also an important regulation is the regulation concerning sustainable forestry. And in addition to this, we have a lot of other and more laws and regulations connected to the forestry sector. Now I will go on with the second part, which is the PFC system in Norway, and give you an information on how the system is organized and structured. First, a very short history of PFC in Norway. PFC Norway was founded in 1999. And in 2000, we had our national certification system approved and implemented. And then we have had, as you see before, three earlier revisions of the system, and now we are finishing our fourth revision. Short about organizations and members, the secretariats, we have our two employees, a national secretary and a marketing manager. And we have 10 members, member organizations representing different interests in sustainable forestry. Yeah, PFC certification in Norway, as mentioned, we have a very large amount of forest area, which is certified. So 7.4 million hectares is certified forest, mainly through group certificates, 12 of them and one individual, and 42,000 forest owners are a member in these groups. And in practice, almost all wood supply to the industry is PFC certified. So the system structure, it's divided into three parts. One organization with the articles of PFC Norway and the PFC N06, which is the procedures for the development and revision of the Norwegian system, and also instructions for the notification of certification bodies. And the second part, which is the forest certification part, which I will come more into, but it consists of in total five documents with the PFC N002 Norwegian Forest, Norwegian PFC Forest Standard, which is the SFM standard. And then the third part, which is traceability and logo use. And it's connected up to the international standard for chain of custody and for trademark rules. Very short about the PFC N 01, which is an overarching document in the forest certification system, giving a history of the forest certification in Norway, a bit about forest in Norway, in the forest in the context of the climate change, and also value creation, some information about the Norwegian forestry policy, the organization of Norwegian PEFC forest certification, document structure, traceability, use of PEFC logo, and also the requirements for the management system of PEFC Norway. Further on, complaints, disputes, specifications and guidelines, and a section about the public access to information and the objectives of the Norwegian forest standard, and how the development in forest has been since the introduction of forest certification, section about changes in the requirements, and that's the changes due to the revisions of the standard and the system. We have a section about monitoring forestry plans and the relationship between laws and certification, and also an overview over relevant laws and regulations for the sustainable forestry. So the SFM standard, the Norwegian PEFC forest standard, in the revised version now, it has 30 requirements that must be fulfilled. And here you see just some of the selected core elements, which is the key habitats, as I mentioned, has to be done and for harvest. And then you have, of course, the important requirements due to for felling and driving in the terrain, which is very important. And also considerations for birds of prey and owls and Cape Kelly leeks, and also consideration and requirements for birds in general. And in the middle here, you have a picture of retention trees, which is an important requirement. So also both retention trees and dead trees is a very important requirement. Regeneration after felling is also important and very important in the whole sustainable forestry management. Outdoor recreation is an important thing in Norway, and making sure we have a good take good considerations for the areas for outdoor recreation is very important. And also the protection of water and the buffer zones along waterways and rivers is an important requirement. Yeah, I will not go deeply into this, but here is you see the part one of the forest standard, which is the management responsibility and planning. And you have in this section 10 different requirements, which is more or less requirements that needs to be fulfilled and done before any forestry measures are done. Second part is the requirements due to the logging and forestry measures. So you have from requirement 11 to requirement 21, you have all the requirements due to the activities in the forest. So both the harvesting, how to take care of waste and contamination, retention trees and dead trees, off-road transportation, long-term timber production, soil scarification and the requirements for that, tree species distribution, the use of pesticides, fertilizations and nutrient balance, and the use of forest tree species, and afforestation and tree species change. And the third and last section is the special environmental values. So here you have key habitats, requirement for biological important areas, considerations for birds of prey and owls, considerations for capercaillie leaks, and also considerations for other nesting birds. We have water protection, wetlands and swamp forests requirements, fire affected forest and requirements on that, and last, cultural heritage and cultural environments. Yes, that was the SFM standard. The next standard in the forestry certification system is the requirements for individual and group certification. These requirements is very much linked up to the ISO HLS / ISO 14001 requirements, and its requirements and responsibilities for both group and individual certificate holders, and also requirements and responsibilities for the group members, so the forest owners who are entering and are a member of a group. So here, the main thing is chapter four, leadership and the context for the certificate holders, requirements for the certificate holders and requirements for the group members, and also performance evaluation, requirements for related to competence. And at last, also, a very important thing, but the improvement requirements. Next standard is the requirements for certification bodies and accreditation bodies. So the, as it says, it has certification body requirements, requirements related to the auditors and the audit procedures, and the criteria for reactions in case of serious errors or non-conformities, and also requirements for the accreditation bodies. Okay, the last part of the presentation is about the standard revision process that we have had in the last 2 years. And I will take you through some of the main things on the in the process. Here you see a timetable for the revision process, and the start of the process. We started in January 2020 with a stakeholder mapping, and also the board of PFC Norway approved the standard setting procedures, which was updated, so it was in line with the PFC international requirements. And they also approved the start of the revision process. And then we had a public invitation and call for participation in February. And we also had a webinar in April. And the working committee, as you see, was established in May 2020. And they have been working since from June 2020 to June 2022. We had a public consultation in from April 2022 to June 2022, a 60 days consultation period. And the working committee reached a consensus on the final draft the 30th of June 2022. And after that, it was approved by the board of PFC Norway in August 2022, and it was submitted for international approval in the 20th of August 2022. Yeah. A little bit more on the start of the revision process. Given that there was a new PFC benchmark standard, the board of PFC Norway decided to start a full revision within the deadline of the periodic review. And as I mentioned, we started before that in January with a stakeholder mapping. And in total, 132 organizations were identified as stakeholders. We had a national webinar in that period to focus on the upcoming revision and the core themes for sustainable forestry, and also information on the revision process and the possibilities to nominate candidates to the working committee. And we had 120 participants on that webinar. In total, there were 19 nominations to the working committee, and also on top of that, nominated 6 observers. Working committee, as you see here, is in total 16 persons, and including the observers, they are in total 22 persons. And we have had a very good representation of core stakeholders. And I would say that PFC Norway made quite a big effort to get the core NGOs to participate, and also other NGOs as stakeholders. And I will say we had succeeded quite well with that. So we have a very broad and good representation from different stakeholders in the working committee. And it's also well balanced, I would say, both between stakeholder groups, but also in the point of gender balance. And in the table, you see in red the new organizations who has been participating in the revision process and in the working committee. As you see, we have quite a good representations from the NGOs, but also other NGOs from the recreation and climate is present on the in the working committee. And also we have from the education, and science and forest research, we have a good representation. Yeah, working committee has been organized in an open and transparent way. The representations and decision making has been balanced, and no single interest has dominated the process. They have, as I said before, have started process and work in 2020 June, and in June 2022 they sent the final draft of the revised standards. They have had in total 34 meetings, and in addition there have been several subgroups that have prepared proposals that in turn have been considered by the whole committee. We also have used a lot of external expertise, both through the observers in the working committee, but also other external expertise from research institutions. And I would say that the use of the external expertise together with the broad representations from different interests in the committee have contributed to significant changes in the forest standard. Yeah, the draft SFM standard, public consultation, and the final draft. The working committee had a consensus on the draft, which was in the beginning of April 2022, and it was out on public consultation. And then during the consultation period, PFC Norway hosted a webinar with a purpose to provide extended information to stakeholders about the draft of the revised forest standard, and also the opportunity to ask questions. And we received 71 responses, which in the Norwegian perspective is quite a large number of responses. It was broadly distributed from different groups, NGOs, both organizations and private agencies, and other public bodies. And the responses has been made available on the PFC Norway's website. And we have received the responses. They have been considered by the working committee in an objective manner. And a synopsis of the received comments and the results of the committee's consideration is publicly available on the PFC Norway's website. And also the information on the synopsis were sent out to all respondents. And several of the received comments were implemented in the standard, which the working committee finalized in the with consensus on June 30th, 2022. Some of the main changes in the SFM standard, there is on the biologically important areas, it's extended requirements for set aside areas on the forest properties. There are also extended requirements for consultations of environmental databases. The consultations for birds has been, and especially for prey and owls and birds in general, and large capercaillie leaks has been extended. There are clearer requirements for increased use of selective fellings. And there are stricter guidelines for setting aside and management of buffer zones, and stricter requirements for the use of foreign tree species, and also clearer definitions and requirements for forestry measures in important outdoor recreation areas. Very short about the other documents. So in addition to the SFM standard, the working committee has also revised the associated standard that constitute the forest certification system to ensure that they meet the international criteria and national expectations. And several adjustments were made, especially on the PFC N03 document, to make sure the standard is in line with the PFC's criteria. National approval and application. The committee had a common agreement, as mentioned, on the final draft in June 2022. And there were no negative votes or any other sustained opposition in the working committee to the final draft. So the final draft were, as mentioned, agreed upon on a working committee meeting on June 30th, and was then sent to PFC Norway. And the board of PFC Norway formally approved the revised system on August the 18th, 2022, and it is was sent in for international assessment and approval. My presentations for the PFC system and the revision of the of the Norwegian system. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Thomas, for this very well-prepared and detailed presentation. I think it was really, really interesting. For me, the most interesting was really all these details you mentioned about the changes in the SFM standard and also dealing with a very impressive number of stakeholders in your national process. I think this is very important, and a lot of other countries will learn from this and probably ask for you how you managed to coordinate with this very diverse set of stakeholders. I think now we have time for questions. I don't see any on the floor yet, but I would have one myself because you mentioned this, the Norwegian forestry contracts is heavy relying on family and private property. And I assume that you you work with group certification to manage those smaller owners. And I just wanted to ask you that roughly at national level, how many forest owners you manage to cover through these group certification in general?
Yes, we have in general or in total, we have about 42,000 forest owners who are members in one of these group certificates.
Oh, this is a very high number.
Wow. Yeah.
So, all right, great. I think I don't see any other questions from the floor for now. I think one of the reasons could be that you really prepared with a very rich information this presentation. I certainly will watch it myself for another time to capture all of it. And I think if there is nothing else from the floor, that I would like to thank you again, Thomas, for being with us today. And I wish everyone a rest of a nice day.
Thank you.
Goodbye.